Hello and welcome to the episode 54 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include the start of the second leg of a tour, a big night out, and the start of a film. On the 23rd of February 1962, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. Then, at 9 and at 10:45 p.m, they performed two slots at a Sam Leach event at the Tower Barroom in Wallasey. As if this wasn't enough, they used their break to sneak in a 30-minute slot at the Technical College Hall in Birkenhead. In 1963, the National Package Tour with Helen Shapiro resumed at the Granada Cinema in Mansfield. Before going on stage, the Beatles crowded in Shapiro's dressing room to watch their second appearance on Thank Your Lucky Stars, aired today between 5:50 and 6:30 p.m. on ABC television and recorded on the 17th of February. Helen was the only artist with a TV set in her dressing room, a privilege of being the top of the bill. In 1964, the Beatles were at the Studio One of the Teddington Studio Center in Teddington to record their second appearance in the ABC television's variety program Big Night Out. After the morning rehearsal, the band spent the afternoon recording a mimed music performance and three comedy skits, one of which saw them entering in a customs office and having their luggage searched, revealing that the bags were full of cash. It was obviously a reference to the Beatles' visit to the United States. The mimed performance included All My Loving, I Want to Be Your Man, Till There Was You, Please Mr. Postman, and I Want to Hold Your Hand, plus Money, That's What I Want, that was edited out from the broadcast. The show was aired on the General ITV network on the 29th of February from 6:35 to 7:25 p.m. and later on in the London area. And this is the time to remind you to visit www.simonmas.com/support and be fab, helping me to put out the best material for your viewing and listening pleasure. You know the drill. If anything else fails, share this podcast on your social media or talk about it with your music-loving friends. Back to business with two entries for the 23rd of February 1965. In London, at the Abbey Road Studios, Norman Smith supervised the stereo mixes of the 11 songs that the Beatles had completed between the 15th and the 20th of February. Yes It Is, You've Got to Hide Your Love Away, If You Got Trouble, Tell Me What You See, I Need You, Another Girl, Ticket to Ride, You Like Me Too Much, The Night Before, You're Going to Lose That Girl, and That Means a Lot. Meanwhile, in the Bahamas, the Beatles started filming their second feature flicks, still unnamed at this stage. The film was intended to be radically different from A Hard Day's Night. Shot in color on various locations in the Bahamas, Austria, and London, featuring a stronger cast and a proper plot, the film did have the same director, Richard Lester. The Bahamas were chosen because the Beatles' financial advisor, Walter Stratch, had set up a tax shelter for the group, ending up living for 1 year in a British colony. Having the group filming over there was considered a gesture of goodwill. Today, the filming started with Ringo listening to conch shells near Mackay Street in New Providence, a scene that was not included in the final version of the film. Later, the Fab Four were filmed swimming fully clothed in a pool at the Nassau Beach Hotel. The intensity of the rhythm of the work at this stage of the band's life can be grasped by a single detail. Today was meant to be a rest day for the band, but they agreed to start filming right away. In 1967, at the Abbey Road's EMI Studios, a recording session began at 7 p.m. with the preparation of the A Day in the Life stereo master by Jeff Emerick. When that was out of the way, the Beatles started to work on a new song, Lovely Rita, completing 8 takes of the rhythm track with John and George on acoustic guitars, Paul on piano, and Ringo on drums. Take 8 was then reduced into take 9 at a lower speed than normal, rising the song up a tone. The session was wrapped up at 3:45 a.m. after Paul had overdubbed his bass part on the new take. Finally, in 1969, between 6:30 p.m. and midnight, the Beatles and Glyn Jones worked at the Trident Studios, preparing a master take for I Want You, She's So Heavy, editing together take 9, 20 and 32 of the rhythm track recorded on the previous day. After that, a rough mono mix of the work was made for John Lennon to take home. This concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. In the episode description, you'll find a link to the bibliography of the show, with plenty of Amazon affiliate links for your Beatles-related shopping. See you tomorrow for more stories and insights. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.